The other portion of the presentation is going to be deal with the resident survey, satisfaction survey, which we will release on Friday, and we'll go through that. Now, part of that is some of the feedback that we've received in the past is, Joe, can you do some education on what can we expect from the survey? Even though it's been the same survey, there's some people, there are new people. What does that exactly mean to us? So while I'm not going to go through that entire portion, I did kind of cut and paste the entire survey into a PowerPoint presentation, and I'm going to hit a couple of key points. And with that being said, we're going to roll. All right, for questions, you know what to do. jkvlive@johnknox.com, calls at 386-456-1558, and text messages at 386-507-4236. Many of you do a phenomenal job of getting us the questions prior to, so I get those, and many times I can build them into my presentation. I've been asked to chat about this a little bit. What is VAL? Many new residents don't necessarily know what VAL is. It is Village Alert Line. That's what it stands for. You will normally hear Shannon's voice. With that being said, we have a limited amount of time. We have like 140 characters and 60 seconds to get our message out. The message doesn't mean that it's always an emergency or it's dire. Sometimes there's a water main break that affects us, and it could be on the side of Orange City that supplies water. We switch over to our own water plant. That's seamless to you. Other times, maybe just a reminder. Other times in regards to the hurricane is where we typically try to use it a lot as we try to push out updates in regards to the hurricane. It can be, but it doesn't necessarily always mean it is dire or it's an absolute emergency. We try to push it out to your cell phone, your home phone, and to your email. We also try to send out an update on Fridays in regards to COVID and what's happening with COVID, and we'll come to that. Gosh, I didn't think I'd be standing here 2 months in a row thanking you for everything that you've done and your patience and understanding during this time, Hurricane Nicole. It was officially a hurricane when it hit. Quickly changed to a tropical storm, and while we were seeing water levels recede to a nice level, that's all gone by. That said, don't be surprised if we don't see our waters recede until sometime in March. It is going to take a water. The water table is extremely high. That's why that water's got nowhere to go. It's extremely high, so it's going to take a long time to be able to let that kind of filter through and down to the aquifer. Good news, maybe we should ship some of this to California, right? Occupancy, I'll go through real quick. Independent living overall is 85.6. As you know, I like to count what's between occupied and sold. Those are people that have put deposits down, a 10% deposit down, and they're waiting for their unit to be renovated, they're waiting for a house to sale, they're waiting for something prior to move in. That's 88.6. Cottages, 274 out of 299. And before you catch me, I will point it out to myself. You're going to say, Joe, 299, it was 311. What's going on? Well, the cottages that were affected on Floribunda that have damage, we have taken those out of service. We need to completely renovate those. So we've taken those out of our inventory at that time. It's changed the numbers a little bit, increases the occupancy, but we still have 9 additional deposits. So it's 283 out of 299 for 94.6 between what's occupied and sold. Many of those residents that were in cottages moved over to apartments. That's 68 out of 101 for 67.3 with 4 additional deposits for that 72 out of 101. Villas, 71 out of 74 for 96%, 2 additional deposits. Villas, we only count as Silverstones and Holly Branch. We do not count right at this particular time. We don't count Valencia Landing. We're tracking that separately for your information and for ours. Valencia Landing is 15 out of 26 for 58%, with 17 additional deposits. Oakview Suites, 39 out of 49, and Majestic Oaks, 112 out of 120. A reminder, at Majestic Oaks, we've taken two hallways out of service just to consolidate our staffing. As you continue to hear people using agency staffing, we've been very fortunate to be able to stay out of agency staffing. That said, it helps us in our planning, helps us with recruiting, because this and the care levels that we have, because people are not scattered all over a 100,000 square foot building. Valencia Landing completion, the only, actually, while some of these dates got pushed back, phase four is set for December 5th. That's because we had an inspection. We have some things we need to do from that inspection. And then 2 weeks after that, what we do is we go through our punch list, make sure everything is perfect, and so then we open that. So we do expect that to open on December 5th with phase 5 and 6 quickly holding behind. And if you remember, phase 8 was actually out to February 23rd, and they have brought that in. So while the other phases get pushed back, the last one has been moved up. So we're at about 85% complete, so early next year we anticipate we'll be completed with Valencia Landing. Now, there's still work to be done. After we get completed with Valencia Landing, we have to do a final paving on that road. That road is not at grade level, so they will come through and they will repave that road so everything drains the way it's supposed to, and we'll be moving nicely. This is going to go quick. Some of this is a repeat, some of this is new. I don't have this in my notes, but a couple of things before I start my informational update. Employee appreciation. I want to talk about that. I have the numbers. I'm just going to tell you. I know it's 400. No? Okay. With that said, with the money that is shared with the employees at a particular rate. For many of our employees, that makes their Christmas. They use those funds and they share it with their family, whether it's a Christmas dinner, whether it's Christmas gift for family, friends, children that they have. That for many people, and while you'll hear it when the gift comes out, many of these employees, it makes their entire Christmas. And it's really heartwarming of your generosity and the kindness that you have shared from yours to make many Christmases. Another announcement. John Knox Village received a donation of $100,000. The donor has asked to remain anonymous, and so we're going to honor that, specifically for scholarships for employees. This is a first for us. We've worked very, very hard to get this plan in place. I know many people have talked to me about this, and we've banged around with the board of directors for a while. We will be using some of that. We're finishing up our policies on how we're going to implement this. We're going to be trying to give money out as soon as the spring semester. But this is for any and all employees. In some cases, it could be a case where it's for an employee's grandchild that is going to school. There is, right now, there's not a limit on that. There's a limit on, we're going to try to make sure, my goal is to build that fund up so every year we can provide scholarships to employees. It's a great recruiting tool. The person that gave the money knew it was a great recruiting tool and has had a phenomenal experience and gave from their heart, and for that, we want to thank them. They know who they are, and I want to personally thank them in front of all of you. So that is an enormous, but that money is set aside specifically for the John Knox Village Scholarship Fund for employees. So quickly, R&R. Gosh, I wish I could say something has changed, but it hasn't. We know they haven't been here in over 8 weeks. I'll tell you this part. It's all now on the legal side. We know they haven't done a roof. They haven't done a roof in 7 weeks. We have finalized a $2.9 million settlement, so it takes it to a $15 million settlement for our roofs. I received a question a couple days ago in regards to Holly Branch. Yes, the roofs on Holly Branch also get replaced. So there's still a lot of work that needs to be done. And remember what their deadline was? originally August 31st, and in no cases it's supposed to go past December 31st. Well, I don't see that not happening. So with that personal information, I know Vicki has been bombarded, thank you, with people updating their information. And in fact, even yesterday we were dealing with a family that wanted to come in but was not on that residence approval and didn't have authorization to go in that, in their unit. I don't, respectfully, son, daughter, I cannot let you in. For whatever reason, the resident made a decision not to let those people in, and I have to respect the resident's decision. There is no contractual obligation for me to let anybody in unless the resident gives me approval. That is one thing I want to make sure that you consider. If something should happen, and who is your backup and who are you going to allow in your particular unit? Because if they're not on your list, they don't get in. With that, we continue to update the information and put it into the red tube. It's a clear tube with red caps on the end, and that stands for resident emergency documents. Also, I have been bombarded with review of long-term care policies. So if you have a long-term care policy and you haven't been contacted by your insurance company, guess what? You will be. I've seen increases up 115% of what your premiums are. Sometimes they phase it in over a 2-3 year period, and people want to know, I'm already paying this and now I'm going to pay double that. While I can't specifically give you advice and tell you what you should and should not do, and I'm going to repeat that, I cannot give you advice and tell you what you should or should not do. I can guide you and let you know if your limits are enough should you go to Majestic Oaks. If you haven't reviewed your policy, if you have a policy and you haven't reviewed it, please review it. Even if it's only been a couple of years, they send out a bunch of information, and I've seen over the last year, I'm going to say I've probably reviewed about 20 policies, and they're kind of all the same. They're raising the rates because of healthcare costs, and people are wondering, do I have enough to go and cover myself at Majestic Oaks? Gatehouse 2, we talked about that. Those contracts have been signed, and it's in the design and development stage. And to let you know, we've finally received the permits for finishing the north side of Valencia Landing fence. Those gentlemen should be starting that project relatively soon because I know supplies are in hand. Fun stuff. We're using technology in the dining rooms. For those of you who may have been in the grill yesterday, you probably saw the little server, electronic server. It's called Beer Robotics. It is to help either serve and or to bus tables. We're piloting that. If we like it, I anticipate we will have 2, if not 3 more of those to use. Why? We're having an incredibly difficult time getting enough staff. If we can focus our staff on the serving portion or on a number of other things, we can use that for people to, we can use that to help bus tables. In addition to that, to help with our recruiting, we've dropped our age for recruiting staff. Normally, we don't take anybody until they're 18 years old. We've dropped it down to 16, and we're going to have 16 and 17-year-olds. We're going to the high schools and trying to recruit 16 and 17-year-olds if they do nothing else but bus tables. They can't work in the kitchen, operating kitchen equipment, because that's against labor laws. We know that. That's why we've always stayed with 18. But if we can focus our efforts on some 16 and 17-year-olds to bus tables, we don't need a lot of them. We just need to take that load off of our servers. Hope that makes sense to you. So there are a number of different little robotic servers and robotic bussers out there. We've decided to try this one, and we'll see. Like I said, we'll see. After 30 days, we'll be sharing with you what our results are. Office of Insurance Regulation Examination covering 9 years. Yes, it's still in process. If you go and you review the information in the binders in regards to our 990, our reports, our OIR reports, etc. Please don't remove those from the binders. Leave them in the binders. If they decide to do a site visit, they will head to the library and they'll make sure that we have all our stuff posted and everything is there in an order. Medicare Part D. Medicare Part D is until the first part of December. If you have not reviewed your Medicare prescription medication plan, do so. If you don't know how, please make sure that you reach out to Callie down at Oak Park Pharmacy and she will help you do that. I know she's done appointments and they continue to do appointments, and they'll help you get the best plan based upon the information that you provide. We're working on an energy conservation program. A lot of this comes from you being shared. Joe, do we have to have all the lights at Valencia Landing on all night long? Well, part of that answer is yes. When it's in construction like that, we do. We need to be able to find out if there's a fault in the wiring, if there becomes an issue. So the lights at Valencia Landing do need to be on in many of those homes. They want to make sure if there's something that's wrong, they find it and they find it early. But I don't know if we're going to call the program Turn Off the Lights, but our recommendation is if you don't need a light, let's turn it off. We're trying to get a little bit more vigilant on our side, making sure that we turn off the lights in some of the common buildings, Valencia Landing, the clubhouse, the Barker Center, and others. But there are other places that we just can't. With that, we've also have looked at a number of rooms that we can put sensors in. So as soon as somebody comes in, the sensor will kick on. You'll hear more about that as we move into the next year. Renaming the old library. There were four people that recommended this name, and it won by a wide margin. Naming the old library is now called the Gathering Place. The Gathering Room was another suggestion that was very close, but the Gathering Place, we will get signage, and from now on, it we may call it GP for short. We call it the Gathering Place. There are maybe a number of things, but we will try to, staff's going to work very hard not to refer to it as the old library. We'll call it the Gathering Place. Resident Satisfaction Survey is out tomorrow, and you will have through the 29th of November to complete that. We're going to get into that in just a little bit. Trafford Widening Project, $1 million price tag is a $1 million on expanding it 6 feet all the way down Trafford, down to Westlake. That seems like it's a little steep price tag for 6 feet, so we've decided to table that for now. Citrus Dining Room repurpose for crafts. I put Michael's name next to that because that project's been assigned to him. He gave me an update, and we chatted about getting that room clear and what we need that room to look like. And then we're in the initial stages for apartment building renovation and stairwells. We're looking at a number of products to replace the carpet that we have on the stairs with something else, and painting the stairwells, kind of giving them a little bit of a spruce. This is for residents in independent living. There is a group, Late in Life Issues. This is a resident-driven group, and they have the Late in Life Issues program, I think is what they're calling themselves. They have a coffee with scheduled for November 30th at 9 o'clock. So Wednesday, November 30th at 9 o'clock here. I suggest either one you attend or two you tune in. It's going to be a good program. They're assisting residents with other issues that you may have, whether it's estate planning, whether it's a passing of a spouse, whether it's you have a spouse that has dementia, a variety of issues. So residents helping other residents. Centrix. Yeah, I know I said we were going to start billing you October 1st. However, accounting got the bills out a little sooner than I anticipated. So you'll see your first bill in December, and we'll figure out how we need to do that. With that, the CEO of Centrix will be here in early December, so I can have a chat with him and walk him through some of the issues that we've had. issue that's been brought to our attention is people on Valencia Landing are having problems with deliveries because UPS, FedEx, even the postal services doesn't recognize Valencia Landing because it's not in their database. So we've started calling UPS, FedEx, Amazon, trying to give them the addresses on Valencia, and so things can be delivered there. As we make progress with that, we'll continue to let you know. As an alternative, typically if you order something, you can put your address, but then you can also put a second address. You can use 101 Northlake. It will come to us and we'll make sure that you get it. So if you're having problems getting deliveries, you're on Valencia Landing, you're having problems getting deliveries, for right now, if you order something, the secondary address that they have in the packet in your order form, you can put 101 Northlake, and we're hoping that it would then be delivered to us, and we will call you so you can come pick it up. Clubhouse, we did evaluate the clubhouse generator. We did put refrigerators and freezers are both on there, elevators, emergency lights, and hot water. Even though our hot water is on demand, it still needs an electric spark to start the gas. So just that little, it doesn't take a lot of energy, it just takes a little electronic spark to get that gas going, and we've done that. So should we be in a situation again, hopefully not, where people were out without power and people need showers, we have the clubhouse where we can do that. Pet policy and dog bites. We have released a new pet policy. Please make sure you go and you look at it. There may have been a version that you saw and it's now changed. I think some things got cut off in the version, but we've replaced that. And review it closely. It also addressed dog bites, and I want to also chat about this. Your dog is your responsibility. I recommend on your renter's policy, strongly recommend, and we may have to mandate it for everybody who's a pet owner for a dog, that you carry additional insurance should your dog bite somebody. That is your responsibility. And I'm certain it's been, and I will make a firm decision, which clearly I'm leaning towards mandating insurance on dogs for that purpose. Oh, that's never happened, right? For that purpose. Should your dog bite somebody and we find out, we will come and have a chat with you and we'll give you a warning. Should it happen a second time, we will give you a second warning. I'm kind of firm. I'm a big baseball fan. 3 strikes, you're out. Any time in between there, should that bite be serious enough, we will ask you to rehouse your pet off campus. We cannot put other pets, and we won't put residents in danger of your dog biting. It is your responsibility to ensure your dogs, all your dogs' vaccines and shots are up to date. But this is one thing that we don't play with, in particular because we have a number of dogs, various sizes. I have a couple of dogs. I have 2 labs. They're the sweetest dogs ever. One of them is 130 pounds. He sees you, he's big, he's black, and if he sees you, he's going to bark and he's going to pull. He scares about 90% of the people. And all he wants to do is come over and say hi. But most people will hurt themselves trying to run away from him versus any damage he would do. That is a real fear on behalf of everybody. And we need to be respectful of that. Our nurse after-hour coverage on 11 to 7, and many times on 3 to 11, 11 to 7, we don't have coverage. And we spoke about this before. What we do is we try to use Majestic Oaks. If the nurse at Majestic Oaks is busy and she's unavailable, remember the people that are at Majestic Oaks have a priority of care. And that is where our first obligation is. Should you hit your call system and you need them, we've instructed, and we will chat about this again We will ask security to respond. Let's be clear. If it's a gaping wound that's bleeding, if it is chest pain, if it is a potential broken bone, or you've hit your head, we recommend you call 911. Don't wait for somebody to respond. Call 911. Now, I know we've had other issues about maybe 911 doesn't know where to go, 911 doesn't respond timely. We have no control over that. But if you call early, you're more than likely to get a response. If you wait for somebody to come that is either delayed or doesn't come at all, it could put yourself in a potential health issue. Don't do that. The call system in your unit, we call a courtesy call. It is not an emergency call. And I want to be clear about this. Emergency medical technicians are not responding. Our nurse will respond and or security will respond. It doesn't mean that you're calling 911. That is not considered emergency. It's a courtesy. You'll hear us use that language very strongly to make sure everybody, because everybody thinks, hey, nurse is going to come if I need to go out and I need to go 911. No, if you have any of those four issues or you feel like you've got uncontrollable pain, call 911. We will at very least get security to respond to you and give you direction. And they may say call 911 because they're not there to assess. With that said, we've looked at a number of programs. We have hired an EMT for the second shift. We widened the recruitment net. We hired an EMT for the second shift. They will come and they will respond on their days off. And we hope to get a nursing student, somebody who's completed kind of basic anatomy and physiology, is able to do first aid. While they won't be able to assess you, they will be able to observe you. We have to, because of the Nurse Practice Act, nurses know this, we cannot use the word assess because they're not assessing you, they're just observing you. If they recommend you go 911, you ultimately have the call, but if they recommend it, we're going to ask you to go. Fair enough? We're going to go through this quick. We did a little bit of this last time. Hurricane Erin, 113 homes without power for 4 or 5 days. With that, 60 trees lost is 75 trees lost. And Nicole has done a little bit more. We have 5 units for roof damage, 17 plus inches of rain. I know the last count I got was 17.6 for this storm. We have 10 residents living on alternative living arrangements. We evaluated that, and I know somebody didn't like the fact that we terminated employees, and maybe I didn't explain that well. We terminated employees because they decided they didn't want to come to work and do their job during a storm after we've put a lot of things in place. You may not like that. I'm okay that you don't like that. I'm not changing my stance, and I'm not changing my policy. So that can be a topic that you and I can agree to disagree on. Hurricane Nicole, Floribunda lift station, while it's working, we have, as you like to say, jerry-rigged it to get it to work. That meter is underwater, and it needs to be rebuilt. And that cost will fall on us. We've chatted with Duke Energy. In addition, we have 7 additional trees either down and or been removed. We have 8 trees that were leaning or split, so we'll be removing those, and I think many of those have been. We had water intrusion in 8 apartments, and we were without power for 6 to 7 hours. And yes, we got a call from the city of Orange City. They thought that we were pumping water across Graves Avenue into the city. And oddly enough, the pond that we have on Holly Branch, which is a dry pond, has a drainage system that just automatically drains it to a different area of the property. That was in place before we even put Holly Branch in place. So we'll work with the city of Orange City to help resolve these kinds of things. We have water problems. They have water problems. So hopefully we can come to a mutual agreement how we resolve both of our water problems. Majestic Oaks, you've known this. I've been banging on this for a while, accredited through JACO for nursing care accreditation, post-acute, and then memory care. Still number two in Newsweek for 2023. We were number two for 2022, and now for 2023, also number two. COVID, just a real quick update as of 11/3, new update comes tomorrow. If you want to go ahead and go to the Florida Health Department website and look at it, positivity rate in Florida is 7.8. It is only down just a mere click. Volusia County is 7.3. Older adult rate is 9.9. We've talked about the green, yellow, and red light. If it's less than 5%, feel free to move about the cabin, so to speak. Do whatever you want to do when you want to do it. Yellow is 5 to 10%. I would consider this yellow. Please use discretion on where you go. If you're going to be going to the Magic game and it's a packed arena, please make sure you're smart about types of things that you're doing and people that you're around. Maybe wear a mask. Red light, if it's greater than 10%. Now, question is, have we seen the last of being over 10%? I agree with you. I don't think we have. We're going into flu season. COVID is going to get matched up with flu, and people are going to think they have flu. Here's just kind of some rules for the flu season. Wash your hands, social distance when in large groups. Consider wearing a well-fitted mask, particularly if you're off campus. If you're feeling ill or feel you have exposure to COVID-19, contact the resident nurse at 1407. It's JKV practices that we ask you to be quarantined. We will provide a COVID test on day 5. Many of the home COVID tests that you have, if you look at the date on them, they are expired. So, while that was a great program, they're already expired. It takes a while for your body to get up to the viral load, in particular if you've been vaccinated. And everybody has heard the age group 20 to 40 are starting to exhibit kind of weird kind of health conditions. I know, and I talked about this last time, my wife's campus, she works for a college. They've had about 7 students that are in that age range, 20 to 40, that have gone to the hospital, and some of them are in ICU with a heart condition. So the only thing they can be able to trace that back to is the vaccine. It is not for older adults. There have not been any older adults that have exhibited any of those symptoms. So, and you're welcome to test earlier using your home test, but that does not remove you for your need to be in quarantine. So you might still show negative because you won't show positive until day 5. Same reminders, keep your distance, stay at home, wear your mask, wash your hands, and sanitize. And now we're going to go to the resident satisfaction survey, and I'm going to go through this rather quickly. It's going to be available tomorrow, November 18th. We want it returned by the 29th. If you take a day or two longer, we're not going to be sideways about that. We're okay. Your responses, we want to make sure that everybody understands this. I've put this in this PowerPoint because even if there's somebody who's not here, they can go to the portal because Shannon will post this. They can go through this portion and they can get the information on the survey. Your responses are anonymous. The survey will, I'm going to tell you, even if you know your answers, I took the survey. I did it electronically. Now, I'm personal disclosure. Yes, I nodded off twice. It's a long survey. When you do it online, it's in excess of 192 questions. That is a lot. Yes, I agree with you. And we've tried to do the best that we can to make those things, but we wanted this, and we're looking at changing things, so look for next year. We're gonna change some things, or we're gonna do things a little bit differently. Give yourself plenty of time. It took me 25 minutes to do it. I know the questions. I knew what my answers were going to be, and it still took me 25 minutes to do it. Each resident should complete their own survey. spouses, significant others, you live in the same household, you each should do your own survey. We strongly urge you to complete your survey electronically. Why? Because then we get the information real time. We will have paper surveys available. We've done a calculation, and even though Joy says she can do it rather quickly, if she sits back there and giggles to herself, you have to figure every paper survey that's done is a minimum of 10 minutes for her to complete. 180 surveys were paper surveys last time. That's a lot of hours. That's 30 hours of input. So please, if you can, complete it. The paper survey is different than electronic. The electronic survey, you have to answer the question. You cannot go on. You cannot save it mid. You can't answer half the questions and say, I'm going to come back and answer this later. I'm going to save it. You can't save it. You have to answer the questions at the front. It doesn't let you move on. You can't skip ahead, and you cannot go back. That's been done to try to expedite things and to get things done quicker. So, with that said, this just gives you a brief outline. You can look at this on your own. Tells you what questions are where, what they're about. And it, for example, facilities and services at the center, the beauty shop, are questions 25 and 26. That's not as important. There is a new question on the survey, and it is question 50 and 51. 50 and 51 on the paper survey, asks you, have you had a stay at Majestic Oaks in the last 12 months? If you have not had a stay at Majestic Oaks in the last 12 months, just say no, and you skip ahead electronically. And you should skip ahead on the paper survey and go to the last question. So read it carefully, and I'm going to show you a couple. And then number question 61 asks you about your experience at John Knox. Question, background. Now, I apologize in advance for the people that are watching this. You may not be able to see this very well. We hope that you can. This is just strictly background. It just helps us categorize people by groups. We've tried to make it as broad as we possibly can so it keeps you anonymous. We have 800 residents on campus. I'm not going to be able to pick you out which one you are, and nor do I need to, but please, it's important that, and electronically, you decide I don't want to answer the question, are you male or female? Well, now you're stuck, because you can't move ahead, and you can't go back if you decide you don't want to answer that question. We're not asking what your email address is, we're just asking if you have one. Why would we ask that question? We want to know how many people are continuing to get advanced with technology. Many people. We believe that, I think last time was 80%+ of the residents had an email. That's a good way for us to be able to reach out to you. And where do you currently reside? A villa, cottage, or an apartment? That's pretty easy to do. You decide not to answer that question, you're stuck. You can't go any farther. Volunteer hours. I promise this is going to go a little bit quicker. All I need is a number. Please don't put approximately 10 hours a month. No, just put 10. You cannot put approximately 10 hours a month. There's only four or five digits available on the electronic version. So it's all we're looking for is a number so we can pull the number. Make sense? So don't try to get creative in, well, I like to do, no, we just want a number. And that is in the village. In the village is within John Knox, whether you're resident council, you work with a committee, your village friends, whatever. Outside the village is, it might be Advent Health, it might be Walmart. You're a volunteer greeter at Walmart that's all we want to know. Communications. The way this format is, this is strictly the paper version. Remember, for each line, for example, electronically, there would be a question in regards to the communications in regards to village life. That question electronically is a question all by itself. Here, you can go down, and if you do it on paper, just clearly check it. Because remember, whatever you do, we have to re-input that electronically. So it is going to take us a little bit of time to do it. That's why we're encouraging you to take it electronically. Village Weekly, all the things, all the communication measures that we use. Nothing has changed on this question. It is all absolutely the same. But each one of these lines is a question electronically. So we have 12 separate questions just on communications for each line. Paper version, all you have to do is check the box. Please, we encourage you to do the electronic version. Qualifier questions. You will notice that there are a number of qualifier questions. And the qualifier questions is do you dine at S.H. Crane's? It's a simple yes or no. You'll notice if you say no, you're going to go to the Bay Dining Room. Guess what? It's going to ask you when you get to the Bay Dining Room. Do you dine in the Bay Dining Room? If the answer is no, put no and go to the next question and you'll skip those. Electronically, it'll skip it for you. Paper, you have to figure out and you have to skip it. We call those qualifier questions because if you're not using the dining room, then you really don't have an opinion. Opinions. Our goal is to have every resident complete a survey. Every resident. We want every resident to feel very, very strongly about their opinion. Good, bad, or indifferent, we just want you to feel strongly about your opinion. What gets things done? We've talked about this before. Comments. You might put, let's go back to very dissatisfied. You pick something very dissatisfied. But why are you very dissatisfied on a particular question? That doesn't tell me the thrust of your issue is. Please share with me why you're very dissatisfied on that. Now, I've read comments all over. One of the typical comments is a broad stroke is John Knox Village has gone to hell in a handbasket in the last 10 years. Dining service has gone to hell in a handbasket in the last 10 years. There have been a lot of things that we have done, and we've done extremely well. Some of that is a balance between us balancing your monthly service fee to the services that we think you should have. Does that make sense? Remember, my philosophy is I can give you anything you want. I can have a chef come walk into each dining room every single meal if that's what you want, if that's what's important to you. But who's paying for it? Point the finger at yourself. I can do anything you want me to do as long as you know who's paying for it. It's you that is paying for it. So we've tried over the last number of years to balance and be value. Qualifier questions. Everybody understand qualifier questions? There's a number of them hidden throughout the survey. Dining, these are the dining questions. I'm going to try to wrap this up very quickly. I'm going to split through because you've all seen this survey. The appearance of the dining of S.H. Crane's. When you walk into the S.H. Crane's, does it meet with your satisfaction? Is there a nice menu variety? My opinion is yes, but that's my opinion. Does it meet your dietary needs? We've struggled with making sure that we have enough vegetarian options. But what's enough vegetarian options? And how many vegetarians do we have? Food quality, some of that is not only the quality of the food, but the preparation of the quality of food. Quantity. I can't say that I've heard many complaints about the quantity of food. Food presentation. Survey, I'm going to go back. Some people will say, you know, we used to get that little slice of lemon. We used to get the little decorative things on our plate. We used to get all that. Yes, you did. But you know why that changed? Because many of the surveys that we got said, I don't need all that extra stuff on my plate. So we changed it. Now, there are some people that, because a lot of people said, I don't need that extra slice of lemon, I don't need the little garnish, I don't need all that, half the stuff I move off my plate and I end up getting thrown away anyway, and that's wasteful. I don't need that. Garnish is important to some, not important to the other. What we saw is that it was less and less important to a number of people, so we removed it. So if you're going to bang us on presentation, be specific about what you want about the presentation. Service quality is strictly the servers, Crane's hours, and then overall satisfaction with SH Crane. These questions are the same exact questions for every dining venue. And here are the dining venues. In this, I just took the number of questions. Crane's, Bay, Curbside, Oak Tree Grill, The Scoop, and the Treetop Lounge. All those questions are the same for every single one of those categories. Now, we've wiped out probably 100 questions on an electronic survey, but only about 21 on a paper survey. Off-campus, this is programs and events, activities, outside dining, if you participate in that. If you never have, just check, never attended. Mall trips, concerts, theater, we want to know what you like. Candace is very, very eager to help renovate and rejuvenate our resident services department and do a lot of very cool things that we've been asking to be done for years. She is the person for the job. We will use this information to schedule more of those things for you. If you tell us that you don't really care for the theater, then that's a small group of people. We will do that for that particular small group of people. If you like concerts, personally I like AC/DC, I'd go to their concert. Then, if you're that type of person, we will try to do those kinds of things also. Make sense? Taste, these are on campus, the taste of, guest entertainment, the evening of celebration dinners, many of these things, educational programs. We're also looking, and I think Candace has already started doing an incredible job for us of bringing in educational programs, and the goal is to continue to do that. Outside experts that can do those things for us. Barker Center. Now, I want to point out one little thing here, and it's the middle question. We didn't want to create a completely new category and blow everybody's mind. It says billiards room next to the Oak Tree Grill. Because remember, the billiards room is not in the Barker Center. It's right next to the Oak Tree Grill. Now, if you've never used it, okay. But based upon that, how satisfied are you? And then the rest of it falls into place. There's beauty shop and gift shop. What I decided to do is consolidate some of the questions. You'll see they're all talk about appearance, space adequacy, equipment, service quality. Main Street Bank. Main Street Bank looks at these surveys. We share with them what their satisfaction number is. They're very, very interested in knowing what their satisfaction number is. And you'll notice that we're not saying the old library. We're saying the gathering place. Spiritual Life Library, Sports Complex and Fitness. One of the next things is the pool. Now, I don't care what pool. We have a swimming pool here in the center building, and then we have one at the Valencia Landing. If you've used the one at Valencia Landing, that counts. If you use the one here, that counts. I want to get your opinion. If you need to say, hey, the pool is worn and not very good repair, I'm going to be able to devise you mean the pool here, not the one at Valencia Landing. Okay? Make sense? But you'll also see, and I put this question in there again, question 43 is, again, a qualifier question. Do you use the pool? If you not use the pool, as much as I'd like you to give me your opinion, if you haven't used the pool, can you really give me an adequate opinion? And then it says, if no, skip to section 7, healthcare facilities and services. Oak Park and resident nurse, pharmacy, rehab, nurse practitioner. Everybody understands nurse practitioner in clinic services is Martha. Everybody understands that? Visiting physicians, if there is a hearing aid, if there's a foot doctor, if there are other physicians that are going there that you happen to be seeing, we want to know that. And then resident nurse. Home health. Again, this is, if you haven't used home health, you just check no, and then you go to Majestic Oaks, and Majestic Oaks is one of the last questions, and this is, have you had a stay at Majestic Oaks in the past 12 months? It's a yes or no. If it's no, then you go to housekeeping services. These are very important questions for us in regards to housekeepers. Many times we only hear about, while many of you send in phenomenal comment cards and you let us know that your housekeeper has done a phenomenal job for you, we look at this survey very, very closely to find out if we have any common issues in regards to housekeeping, security, maintenance, and grounds. Transportation. Am I going too quick? Good. In the middle of transportation, again, I want to make sure that you see that there's a qualifier question, maintenance, grounds, residential areas. Residential areas are around your cottage, village, villa, or apartment. Non-residential are the common areas, like Central Park and the Pavilion, around the Barker Center. Those are non-residential areas. Oak Park. And last, and certainly, of course, not least, would you recommend JKV? We want you to feel enthusiastic and happy that you're here. If you're not, we want to know that too. And it's helpful if we know why you're not. The last two and a half years have been incredibly hard on everybody. We're not asking you to pull your punches. If you're unhappy about something, we want to know that. We want to make sure that starting out this new year in 23, that if we can get it fixed, we want to get it fixed quickly. I have all my directors in place. I have not had that in 2 years. So everybody is on board. Everybody is staff, directors, managers, supervisors are all on board. If there's something that you don't like, please share it with us. Comments are the one thing that gets things done. And you can look at Joy now, and I will say this, and she will shake her head. The first thing I ask Joy to do is put together the comments. She puts together the comments even before she calculates scores and does anything else, because that's what we push out to directors and managers so they can start working on some of the common issues that we find. Now, you may have a one issue that you don't like something, and it's just you. Come talk to us. Many of you send me emails, will call me, will set appointments, you'll talk to Vicki, you'll go right directly to Stan or Michael or whomever. You're welcome to do that. With that, questions?
Earlier with the R&R Roofing, you mentioned that you've gotten attorneys involved and it's gone to settlement. Has that affected the roofing project?
No. And let me be clear about that. Us getting legal involved hasn't affected the roofing project because I only got legal involved this week. I've given them 8 weeks to get their act together and to get some roofs done and get some roofs completed. They have an excuse for about a week, right? The hurricanes, I'll cut them a break. You can't be on a roof during a hurricane replacing a roof. I'm good with that. But after that, even if I give them 2 weeks, there's still 6 weeks where we haven't seen any work done. And, you know, to say everybody else is getting roofing supplies, but yet they can't. And they started this back in February. So.
How many residents have been COVID exposed that was not included in the earlier slide?
We have three and three. Three in independent living with, it's three and three in independent living. Three people that are positive, and of course they have a significant other. And those three are then their spouses are in quarantine. And then we have three between Majestic Oaks and Oakview Suites. Oakview Suites had two. There was somebody who was positive at Majestic Oaks. The ones in Oakview Suites went down to Majestic Oaks, so all three are at Majestic Oaks.
Back to the survey. When it comes to answering the questions on SH Cranes, what if you only do takeout from SH Cranes? How should they answer those questions?
Okay, great. If you only do takeout, answer that question under curbside and put comments under curbside. Okay? Yes?
Floribunda Pond. We're flooded out down there. We have the fountain is not on. It's stagnant floodwaters there. And we also have a mosquito problem. And also, when is the water going to be evacuated out of that area? Because even the ones that are left there are still suffering, and certainly the people that have been moved out are suffering.
There's no water, there's no place for the water to go from the Floribunda Pond. Where we would be able to, where we could push that, there is no room to put that, unless we can find a way to put that, take that water, push it all the way to Holly Branch, and dump it into the dry pond in Holly Branch. The city's going to get on to us, because that water now, what did I just tell you, drains down through the system and goes across Graves. And there's no room for water on Graves to go, because during the storm, Graves had flooded. The city today. Actually, I think the city is going to be on campus today looking at our problem and to see if they can help us derive any solutions. If we can dredge underneath, if we can go dig something across on Graves. Our fear is putting on the fountains of throwing stuff in the air. And because it's getting cooler, people are going to have their windows open. We can reevaluate that if people feel differently. The stuff that might be in that pond, that aerator pulls it and it pulls it up, it's still going to get, that stuff is going to get pushed in the pond. So we continue to work and evaluate Floribunda on a daily basis to see what we can do. And we will we'll announce if we can do something different or we come up with another solution, we'll announce what we can do. But there's really nowhere for that water to go. The mosquitoes, yeah. Mark has contacted Volusia County to spray. And so you should see them out in regards to spraying.
The streetlights down in that section are all out also. Is that because it's underwater or is it because they're out?
It's the first I've heard about it, but let me check. I've only been there when it's light, so. But we'll look into that.
I was wondering when they would be cleaning the gutters because they are just overfilled and blow off the driveway and then a wind comes and it's back again. So you know.
I'm going to say that's probably going to be a while before we start cleaning gutters. One, Grounds is trying to catch up on the variety of stuff that they have. The leaves are going to start falling out of the trees. And what they'd like to do is they don't want to have to come back on every couple of days to take care of leaves. But I will put it, I'll make sure it gets on their list and they can get it addressed. Yes?
Regarding Centrix, there are some residents that still had not received the new equipment switchover. There are approximately 60. Will Centrix be coming in when the CEO comes in to do that, or is that going to be on John Knox?
Haven't received new equipment. What new equipment?
The Grands boxes.
They're still using Grandstream?
Correct.
Okay.
And I did speak with Centrix Ray about that, and he just said that he didn't know when that was going to happen, so I didn't know if you had any information. One of the residents is asking from Holly Branch.
This is the first I've heard that they haven't been done. So please write that down for me, and I will contact them today. Other questions?
I had one more that came in by text. Do you have an update on the solar panels?
I do.
Would you like to provide it?
I plan I will do an update, I'm going to guess, in January on the solar panels, if I have my information complete, because what I'd like to do is I'd like to do compare the last number of years of a full year. The reason I do that is because that's exactly when I'll do my presentation to the board of directors at the January board meeting. With that, I'm going to guess I may not do a chat in December. I pass in December, so I may not. I'll make a decision on that in the next couple of weeks. So if you don't see me doing a chat in December, I've given you warning. But if I do, we'll know that in the next couple of weeks. Yes, ma'am.
I just want to assure everyone that Employee Appreciation Fund made the goal and went over, but don't want to steal the thunder from that committee from when they announce it.
Okay, that's fine. What she said is she said that they'll be making an announcement in regards to Employee Appreciation Program. They exceeded their goal, but the committee wants to announce, be able to announce that. Yes, sir.
Joe, for many years, we've been allowed to take outside guests on the bus to concerts and shows. And my sister-in-law is coming for a visit, and I've been told I can no longer take her to a concert or show with me. Is this a permanent change now?
No. Typically, that has always been based on, in the past, that's been based on availability. If there are available seats, because residents come first. If there's availability, I don't know that we've actually changed the policy. I know that sometimes they leave it open because they want to make sure they have enough seats for residents that are going. And they have the best based upon the bus that's being driven. If they have enough, I have no issues with her taking the bus with you.
I was not given that excuse. I was told that it's simply a policy. You can no longer take an outside resident.
Well, what was discussed is liability. Should our bus driver be in an accident? We have somebody who is not a contract resident, doesn't have a contract with us, and if they get hurt, what that kind of liability goes through, that didn't filter back to me that would be an issue, because there are other organizations that do the same thing.
Joe, one other question on the floor abundant. Have you discussed or thought of dredging it to accommodate a bigger area for it to go into? Because all it is a big old pond. It's just a hole in the wall. You know.
Well, if you remember, we did. We just did dredge the floor abundant pond this past year.
Yeah, but that dredging, not one shovelful came out of it. All you did was make the banks look pretty. Like
no.
A golf course, and golf courses can flood, but where homes are, they flooded.
I'm going to respectfully disagree, because I want to say there were a number of double-digit dumpsters full of stuff that came out of there. Okay, you're saying no. I'll check on it, but it was dredged. And we have the bills... And we have the bills to show for it, too. So, because I'm not saying you're wrong, but I'll look into it. Okay? Anything else? All right. With that being said, have a great holiday. Have a nice Thanksgiving, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks for your time.